Iran reportedly is still allowing inspections and complying with the nuclear agreement it signed in 2015, even after President Trump withdrew the U.S. from the deal. Ambassador Wendy Sherman spent 4 years negotiating with Iran and world leaders on the nuclear accord, even powering through several minor injuries during the process. She also worked for the Clinton State Department, where she was a policy coordinator on North Korea. The distinguished diplomat began her career as a social worker. Her new book is Not for the Faint of Heart, Lessons in Courage, Power, and Persistence. She explains how people can apply what she learned in high-stakes negotiations to get what they want in everyday life. We love this. Sherman has just been appointed the new director of the Harvard Kennedy School Center for Public Leadership. Good morning.
Good morning, Norah.
And congratulations on that appointment. Very exciting.
Thank you very much.
There's a lot to talk to, and I want to get to the Iran and North Korea stuff in just a minute. But first, for someone who's negotiated deals with Iran, what can we learn from your career about just everyday type of negotiations we may have?
I think that what I want people to understand is that to do a good negotiation, to really be a good diplomat, you need courage. You need to be able to persist. You need to understand you've got to have a team around you, just like we have to have families around us to be able to get through our day and to get through our careers. We have to be able to really understand the power in our relationships. You know, I've been very fortunate. I've got now a 38-year marriage, and it's because we understand what we come with to that marriage and we help each other out. So what I've tried to do in this book is take this high-stakes negotiation, as you say, about Iran and North Korea, Middle East peace, Cuba, and say, here's a skill set that we all can use in our everyday life to try to make things better and to own our own power.
Well, you write about negotiating during the Iran deal. You write about crying at one point, even because one offhand comment that you made led to death to Wendy Sherman chants in the streets of Iran. I think about being authentic because I thought about how you write about that in the book, but you also have to watch what you say because it can be incredibly dangerous.
Indeed, it is incredibly dangerous. I regretted having made that statement.
What was the statement?
The statement was that deception is in their DNA. It was an answer to a question from a senator in a Senate Foreign Relations Committee hearing, that led to death to Wendy Sherman on the streets of Tehran. I also, during this negotiation, had emails pop up to both me and my daughter that my husband was having an affair in Europe while I was negotiating. I never quite found out who did that, though these days we might have some clue about who's sending those kind of emails.
Yeah.
So there were lots of obstacles along the way, but I think one of the things I've learned through life is I'm going to come out the other side. Mm-hmm. And if I can gather people around me to support me, every place I've worked, I've created a support group, largely of women. I think you both probably understand this, John. You probably understand it in your own way as well. But I think women in the workplace need a support group to know that they're not crazy, that they can juggle, if you're a mom, which I was, juggle what they have in their lives and come through the other side. And I think that is a sense of confidence that we all need to make it through life.
Yeah.
Wendy, let me ask you about the ability diplomats need to have to read the person across from the table, often from another culture. Give us what it's like to negotiate with the North Koreans, who you spent a lot of time with and who are obviously very much in the news today.
You really do have to understand, and quite frankly, John, the difference between autocrats and Democrats is autocrats really are impulsive. They are short-termers. They think about what they want. Democrats think long-term, understand history, understand that we have an obligation to the future and to understand those cultures, so that when you're sitting across from North Koreans who live in this tiny little world, more a cult than a country, they really are cut off from the world. Kim Jong-un has nothing to do except care about the survival of himself and his regime, whereas the president of the United States, most presidents of the United States anyway, believe that they have a responsibility for many, many things and the safety and prosperity of the world.
Yeah. You've been to North Korea.
Yes.
That's right. And when we were reporting there, our government minister said, you know, we all want denuclearization in North Korea, but we want everyone to play by the same rules. Is there a difference, quickly, Wendy, if you could, between how North Koreans view denuclearization and Americans?
Absolutely. For us, we mean getting rid of their nuclear weapons and their long-range ballistic missiles that could deliver them. For North Korea, denuclearization means that we should leave the Korean Peninsula with all of our troops, that we should make sure their regime survives. I think that the president, Secretary Pompeo, now the new envoy, Steve Biegun, have a very, very, very tough road ahead. And I don't think they have a plan for getting to the end of that story.
Mm. Ambassador Wendy Sherman, thanks so much. Yeah. The book is Not for the Faint of Heart.